Hey everyone, and welcome to Transient. I'm Eitan Reiter, and today we're going to make some electronic music. If you like electronic music, this episode is for you because we're going to recreate Robots by Kraftwerk. For those of you who don't know it, shame on you, it goes something like, "We are the robots." We're going to start with the kick drum. Make sure it's not too long and in the right key. I've added some more drive to give it character. Then even a bit more, and a bit of EQing. You don't have to use these many EQs, I just do it so I can retrace my steps. The kick is being sent to the track's auxiliary reverb. This is what the wet signal sounds like. Next is the bassline. Here's the full MIDI. Notice that the notes change throughout the track. It's recreated from two sawtooth oscillators. One's got one voice and the other has seven. The volume envelope is set to be pretty short and clicky, however there's a bit of release and attack to avoid digital clicks. The sound is also going through a low pass filter with some resonance and key tracking. And both velocity and even more key tracking are controlling the cutoff. A MIDI effect is used to increase the velocity randomness. This makes the bassline sound a bit more alive. Then a bit of high cut and some more EQing is applied, a compressor to make the sound more stable, and some more EQing and distortion. And again, the reason that I'm using so many EQs is because each one of them is making a very subtle change to the sound, and this way I can examine them and retrace my steps. For example, if this wasn't a reproduction project, I could just use one or two EQs and shape the sound however I want. And now the auxiliary reverb and delay to complete the sound. Next is this plucky lead sound. For this you're going to need a pulse with a very narrow pulse width and another one octave above. The volume envelope is set to be very short and the filter is set to low pass. The modulation envelope is set to a very short decay and controlling both the cutoff and the phase. Notice that the sound's decay is being automated. One easy way to do that is by using Ableton's macros, mainly because you can set limits and then record automations by jamming more freely. You can assign many parameters to one knob and then record very interesting automations. Some EQing is applied to the sound, along with some overdrive and saturation. The idea is to make it a bit thinner but also stick out in the mix. And last, the sound is also being sent to the track's auxiliary reverb to give it some more space. Next up is the vocoder. Like any vocoder, you have to start with MIDI notes. Then I recorded myself saying the words with a strong accent.
We're charging our battery.
Trying to imagine what the original source would have sounded like before using the vocoder. I've used some EQing, overdrive, and compression in attempt to resemble an old microphone.
We're charging our battery.
Sometimes it's easier to achieve a certain sound if you process it before it's entering a certain effect, rather than after. Be sure to experiment with both of these options. The vocoder is set to sound as retro as possible.
We are the robots.
I've used some overdrive on top.
We are the robots.
And a second layer that's playing only the high frequencies of the dry signal, just to make the lyrics more understandable.
We are the robots.
And then some noise gate, a bit more EQing, and the chorus effect. I've chosen to use Ableton's operator as the synth that's going into the vocoder. It's playing three sawtooth oscillators in three different octaves, mixed in a way that sounded right. Next is the kind of laser snare sound. I've used MIDI effects again to give the velocity randomness. The sound is made from a one-voice sawtooth. The volume envelope is set to be very short. The sound is going through a low-pass filter with some drive and resonance. And to make the sound a bit more alive, the velocity is controlling the cutoff in a subtle way. The modulation envelopes are controlling both pitch and cutoff to give the sound a zappy effect. A compressor is used to make it even more stabby, some EQing, overdrive, and some more EQing just to get the sound right. Then a noise gate is used to make it even shorter. Make sure you get the right length and a very sharp volume envelope. And last, some more EQing to bring out the mid-range. It's also been sent to the track's auxiliary reverb so it can blend inside the mix. Next up is this chord sequence. A 5-voice sawtooth oscillator with some detune, and a short envelope with some release and attack to make it smooth. The sound is going through a low-pass filter with some resonance, a bit of key tracking, and some drive. An LFO is controlling the filter cutoff, using a very slow rate to give the sound its movement effect. And now to achieve the right character, some overdrive and EQs are being used. Like most sounds here, this one is also being sent into the track's main reverb, so it can blend into the mix. Next up is the pad sound. I'm using Silent One for most of the sounds, but you don't also have to use it. You can and you should use any synthesizer that you feel comfortable with. What's most important is for you to be able to create whichever sound you can think of in the most fast, accurate, and comfortable way possible. So the pad sound is pretty simple. It's made from one 5-voice sawtooth oscillator, going through a bandpass filter with some resonance, and a very long attack and release to make the sound smooth. The LFO is controlling the filter cutoff and set to a very slow rate. An EQ is being used to roll off some of the high frequencies, and the sound is being sent into the track's main reverb. Now last, but definitely not least, the effects. It starts with one long note, going through a low-pass filter with a lot of resonance. The LFO is controlling the pitch in a subtle way. And distortion is applied in a small amount. And then to complete the sound, the cutoff is being automated. One more short note that's playing a sound very similar to the previous one. Also, make sure you set the distortion in the right amount. This next sound is playing a bunch of short notes, playing a noise oscillator with a very short decay, going through a bandpass filter. Some EQing and overdrive is applied. This one is a very simple sine wave sound. You actually have to add a second higher octave, and the key here is to get the portamento time right. This may be the most complex sound in this song. It's made from 2 retrigged sine wave oscillators, one playing 1 octave above the other. The LFO is controlling the volume, and the key track is controlling the LFO. This is what gives the sound an FM effect. Then some EQing and a few ring modulators to get the sound right. A short delay and reverb is applied, and some low pass filtering. Now let's listen to the full reproduction. Quick reminder, the project file and the sounds are available for free in the link below. If there's a song you'd like us to remake or a technique you'd like to learn, please let us know in the comment section below. For more videos like this one, subscribe to our channel. See you next time.